Hey guys, welcome back to another video, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to add a button in Android Studio. And in this video I'm going to be showing you guys three ways, not just one. So let's just get started by first opening Android Studio. After it's open, let's create a new project. Let's create an empty views activity, but you can do whatever you want. So let's create the activity and let's call it button demo, and we're going to use Java. We're going to use API 29, that should work, and I'm going to use Groovy. Okay, now the next step is to just wait a few moments as your Gradle syncs and everything else, and once it's done, it should look like this. So before anything starts, I'm going to start my emulator, and if you don't have one, you can create new virtual device and create some phone, like right here. I'm using Q for the system image, and then just press finish and you're good to go. I have a couple here, so I'm going to click on one and start it up. And while that's starting up, we're going to go to our code, and we're going to go to our activity main XML. And if you don't know where to find that, if it's not up here, you can go to res on the side, and then under layout, it should be right here, and it'll look like this. If this is right here on design, it'll look like this. Yeah, and this is a constraint view, which can be a little annoying if you're new to Android Studio, so we're going to convert this view to a linear layout. And we have some text here, as you can see. If we zoom in, see it says hello world up there. It might be a little blurry, but that's okay. And we can actually set its ID up here, or if we click up here, we can split this or just look at the code, and this code makes up like our design. So we're gonna change this text to click button, and under this we're gonna have a button. So we're gonna go back to this view by clicking this, and we're gonna drag in this button right there. As you guys can see, it might not look that good as in the design wise, because it's like pushing each other together. But we can fix that if we go in our linear layout here, right click, convert orientation to vertical. And now it still might not look that good, but we can fix that if we go over here into our code. So first, what I'm going to do is I'm going to set the padding on everything at the very top to 16 dp, so you can see everything kind of like zoomed in a little bit. You guys can see this button is kind of like big over here, so we're going to remove that by removing this layout weight down here, and should go back to normal. And we can set the layout gravity to center, and that should center it. And then we can also do that up here for our click button. And then for padding, we can put this up to like 56, and that's like good enough, I guess. So we have click button, and then a button down here, and we're going to name it click me. That's the text that's going to appear down here for our button. And you guys can see we have some ID here. This is like how we're going to refer to it in our Java code. Our button is called button, but we're going to call this click me button. And this over here, our text view, does not have an ID, so we're going to give it an ID of text 1. I mean, it could be anything, but we're just going to call it text 1. And now we're going to go to our Java code. And first, we're going to create some of these things that we have here. So we have a text view and we have a button. So we're going to add those here. So we're going to make our a private text view and a private button. Now it's okay guys, if it's red, we can just alt enter on it or just hover over it and import the classes, and the error should go away. And then in your onCreate, which is what runs after your app starts, we have to like set these to their IDs. So find view.id, and then we write r.id dot, and then put the ID. And that was text one for the text. And then we're gonna have to do the same thing for our button, but with our button's ID. And these might show red, but you can just ignore that. It's just Android Studio being bad and annoying. So the next step is that if we ran this right now, you're gonna notice nothing's gonna happen when we click the button. But that's okay. In order to make it work, we can go here on our button, and we're gonna create a class first. Class listener implements view.onClickListener. listener, and go like that, and we're going to import that, and then go over and implement methods, say okay, and it'll generate this method down here, and this code right here will run when the button is clicked. So, and if we want that to actually work, we have to go on our button. So we're going to call button and set on click listener, and we're going to write listener because that's the listener we gave it. Oh, this won't work because we have to make a new object. So we can just go with new listener and then put that right there. And then in our on click, we can say text view dot set text button has been clicked. And if we do that and we run our code, we're going to notice it's going to work and we're going to be able to click the button and it's going to change the text. Okay guys, so the code has run by pressing the run button up here, and now it's on the phone, and if I click this button, it has been changed, so the button has worked. But that's only one of three ways that we can do this. The next way we can do this is where we see set onclick listener. What if we first comment this out? We're not using this now. And in here, we put a couple spaces so you guys can see better. We write new onclick listener. So this is like this, literally the exact same thing as this and this, but now it's like less code. We didn't have to make a separate class down here. We can just do it right here with our button. And this is the exact same thing and will work the exact same. And we can make it even simpler if we replace with lambda. And it's literally this simple. Now it's a one-liner. We're gonna go back and leave it like this so you guys can see that. And for the third way, we're gonna first comment this out. And then down here, we're gonna create a new method called public void my listener, or it doesn't matter what you call it, but we're gonna call it my listener, or I think I spelled it wrong, doesn't matter. And we need a view right here as arguments, and down here we can run this code that we wanted to run before, and it'll work the exact same way. Now as this code is right now, nothing will happen, but we have to go back to our XML, and in our button we add a new thing called onclick, and put our listener name in there. So this listener is the same thing that we wrote over here, and if we run this code, you're gonna see it's gonna work. So let's click the button, and it's clicked. All right guys, adios.